This is Country Cottage Needleworks, No Place Like Home series. This is the first installment, which is called Snow Place One. Now then, I've been asked on other videos to show how to get straight margins if you're not going to use a rotary cutter and a ruler to cut down your sides. So I'm going to act like I don't own these today, and we're going to learn how to cut sides down and still get straight material edges. So my project is done on 36 count vintage country mocha. I've stitched it 2/2, and so what that translates into, that is a 36 count fabric, means that there's 36 threads per inch on this linen. Most sewing machines have, from the edge of a presser foot to where the needle comes down, if it's going straight down in the center, is approximately 1/4 of an inch. And for our purposes, that's how I calculate seam allowances. So I want very little linen showing between my stitched piece and my complementary fabric, which is going to be this. Isn't that going to be beautiful? So how do we know where to cut around this this stitched piece? I'll tell you. 36 threads per inch. I want 3/4 of an inch. 36 divided by 4 is 9. So that means in a 1/4 inch, there's 9 threads. To get 3/4 of an inch, you take 9 times 3, which is 27. So I'm going to count 7 strands of threads, 7 threads from the edge of my stitch design, and I'm going to place a pin on all 4 sides. Let me do that, and then I'll be right back. Okay, here we are back, and I have measured my 27 threads from the edge of the stitched piece to the top, and I want to check it just to make sure that what I'm telling you is really true, that 27 threads is 3/4 of an inch. And you will see that I am right, that here is the 3/4, and right to the edge, so it is. 3/4 of an inch is 27 strands, just like you would think on a 36 count linen. So it doesn't matter where you start, top sides or bottom, you carry this line all the way out to the edge. I've done that here, and so I know where I need to pull my thread. And I place a pin right where the 27th strand of linen is, up from the edge, up from the stitched piece. I've carried that out over here to the edge, and now the length of the thread right above this place, I'm going to just pull it out. And you just grab it with the edge of a pin, and then you pull it, if you can grab it. And you can see that I am grabbing the one just above because it's pulling my pin out. So I'm going to get like a tweezers here to get a hold of that thread and yank it. Can you see that there is a line there? A line that you can cut right on. Can you see that right there? See that line? That's where we pulled the thread. Okay, so now we're going to go up from this pulled thread up all the way from this pin where the 27th is. and you pull that thread. Okay, so I found it. I pulled the thread to get it started right here. And there, can you see that that's pulled? That thread's pulled. So we've got two sides. Now we're going to pull this one down here at the bottom. I'm going to follow this line all the way across. And I put my pin, it's all the way across. I pulled the thread and now I'm going to pull this one. Now we've got it down here, all the way up this side, across here. This is our last one. Another way you can do is you have the, I've showed you how you go across. Now, if you have the line marked, all you have to do is go to the thread above it and pick it out and pull it. So we'll do that technique on this one. So here's my line. Here's where my 27th thread is. I'm going to the one directly above it. I'm going to clip it and then I'm going to pull the one side and then the other side if I can get a hold of it. This one's being a stubborn thread. So when you have a stubborn thread, you just kind of have to tweeze it out until you get a long enough length where you can get a grab on it and pull it. Okay, I got one side pulled. Now I got to get the other side. Okay, there. So if you can see, we've got the thread pulled on all four sides. Now I'm just going to cut right where that thread was laying, and that's going to give us our cut project. Now then, I am going to say, while this is a very worthwhile method, I don't like this method just for the fact that it takes too long. I can't see the threads that well, first of all, especially when they're very tiny threads, like 36 count. I can't see them. And I'm confident that my sides are straight with my rotary cutter because I count twice. Measure twice and cut once. But this is a way that if you don't have a rotary cutter, this is a way that you get straight sides every time. by pulling threads. So there's our extras. We're going to throw those away. Here is my ready to sew piece. So what will we do next? The next thing we're going to do is we're going to cut our backing and our side sashing fabrics. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut a two inch strip of fabric, and I'm going to do it on the end here, and I'm going to do it with rotary cutter because that's the way I roll. A rotary cutter, if you save your coupons from Hobby Lobby or wherever, Joann's, you can get them for not that much money, and let me tell you, it's worth it. So the first thing I do on a brand new piece of fabric that I bought is I even up the salvage edge, or the cut edge, the edge that they cut it off the bolt, because 9 times out of 10, it's not straight. And I don't measure from the salvage edge, which is this edge, if you can, let me pull it so you can see. This edge down here, this is called the salvage edge. I don't cut from that edge. I cut from where they fold it onto the bolt. And this is 46 inches wide, so folded in half, this is 23 inches. And it's measuring that, so I know that this is a good fold and I can cut from this edge. So I'm going to even up where they cut so I don't waste any fabric in future when I cut off of this fabric piece. You just want a straight edge. Okay? That's how you even up a yard. Or a cut of fabric. I'm going to go 2 inches. I want 2 inch sashing strips. I'm measuring, make sure this is even. That's straight across. It is. I'm going to hold it tight. And I'm going to cut all the way down the length. Okay? We're going to set this to the side for right now. Now then, here's my 2-inch piece. We're going to cut the top and the bottom, the sides first. Because if you think about it, I want my seam, I'm going to sew the sides on first, so both of these sides, and then we'll go across the top, okay? So we're going to cut off the salvage edge. And then we're going to do 2 lengths of fabric like this. Okay? So we got 2 lengths for the sides. Now then, when I'm cutting the top and bottom pieces, I just lay these out by the side like this. And then I'm going to cut one for my top. Right here, and then lay it down here, and one for my bottom. Before we cut our backing piece, I want to go ahead and sew on these sides. So let me iron these first. We're going to iron these flats, and then we're going to go over to the sewing machine, and I'm going to show you how I iron on my side sashings. Give me a minute, and we'll be right back. Okay. We're over here at the sewing machine. I've got it threaded with white. There's white polka dots in this, and that to me is good enough. These, of course, would be the top and bottom sashings, so we're going to set those to the side for right now. These are the side sashings, and what we're going to do is pretty sides together. We're lining them up with the edge of the linen. You can put a pin here. If you're uncomfortable, you can just put a pin in there, but I'm just going to sew. So line up the edge with the edge of the linen, load it on your machine, presser foot right along the edge of the material, and we're going to sew. Sink our needle. We're going to hold these pieces so they're perfectly straight. Not hard, don't pull. You're just going to gently hold them, and we're going to begin to sew. Reverse to lock, and then straight down. Straight seams. One stitch or two back to lock. We're going to clean off our dirty edges right now. Our, not our dirty edges, you know what I mean. Okay. So here we have, that's what it's going to look like on that side, okay? And you want to visually kind of look to make sure that, you know, you're not wonky, that it's not wavy, that it's straight, just like that one. Okay, so we're going to do the same thing. Let me move it down just a little bit. On this side, line up our material with the top and the bottom and all along the sides. Load our machine, the edge of the presser foot right along the edge of the material. We're going to sink our needle. We're holding this gently but firmly, and we're going to go forward a couple stitches, back a couple of stitches to lock, and then straight down the side. Back and forth to lock. Okay, there we go. Now then, at this point, I'm not going to show you this, but I'm just going to explain it to you. What I'm going to do is I'm not going to press open these seams. I'm going to press this over like this, because if I press open the seams, which means it's going to be like this, you'll see that material on the back side here, because this linen is a loose weave. So we're just going to press it flat like that. So I'm going to go press both sides. Then you see how I have this material up here at the top. I'm going to go and cut this material straight across with the edge of this linen to make that clean, and then I'll be back here at the sewing machine. So give me just a minute to do those two little quick things, and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. I've pressed this just flat like that, and I've trimmed my edges, tops and bottoms. Okay, so now I'm going to take my top sashings, and I'm going to lay them right along the edge. Now I've overshot. You can see I've overshot, and that's okay. I like to play with, so I have enough and length, so that it's not like, oh gosh, there we go, I don't have enough to cover the whole thing. I always overshoot because it's easier to square up those edges at the end. All right? Okay, so I'm going to load this up, presser foot right along the edge of the material, sink my needle. I'm going to line this up because it'll get wonky donky when you load up on your sewing machine. Now then, I have you noticed I'm not using pins? But I do this a lot. So what you can do is use pins if you're a little bit uncomfortable, so that you know that it's not sliding, okay? I'm just, now see, I've pulled too much here and I've talked too much. Okay, load it up. Presser foot right on the edge. Hold this gently, sink my needle, two stitches or so, reverse the lock. And then all the way to the edge. Clean up your edges. You can cut this one off. And then let's check to make sure our seam was straight. And it is. Now we're going to do the second, the bottom. Again, we're going to take our material, line it up along the edge, feed it into the machine, presser foot right along the edge of the material, sink our needle. Gently hold this and start sewing a couple stitches. Back stitch a couple to lock and then on to the end. Clean up our edges. All right, so what am I going to do now? I'm going to press these open, and then we're going to go over to the cutting table and we're going to make some decisions. Let me get that done. Let me press it open, and then we'll make our decisions. Just a minute. All right, I pressed it open, as you can see, or not pressed it open, I pressed it on the back, as you can see, and now I'm going to even up my edges and make some decisions about how much I want this on all four sides. Right now, this is about 1 3/4 wide margin. I want it to be 1.5 inches. So I'm going to measure 1.5 inches seam, and I'm measuring from my seams because those are straight seams right across the top here. I've laid the 1.5 inch line right along the top edge seam where I've sewn to the linen, and I'm going to cut. Okay, I'm going to do the same thing on the bottom, 1.5 inches. Remember to measure twice and cut once. Okay, now I'm going to do the sides, 1.5 inches. Measure twice. I'm following that seam. I'm following two seams on this one because we're going to follow the side seam and that top seam. Inch and a half, 1.5 inches, straight across. And 1.5 inches on this side. All right. Now then. So, I'm going to throw this away. I've got our cleaned up sides. Now then, I'm going to come back to my fabric and I'm going to cut. Let's see how big this is. This is almost 7 inches wide by 8 inches. So we're going to do about two 4x9 pieces of fabric, okay? You get your fabric. And I'm going to open it up. And I'm going to cut 2 4x9 pieces of fabric. So I'm going to line up 4 inches and I'm going to go down to 18 inches. So you can see, I'm going to cut this edge down here first. Fold this over, and then from here all the way down. All right. fold this up for storage. Now I'm going to cut. I'm going to cut this salvage edge off because I actually cut five because I was working along a salvage edge. Okay. Now then we're going to cut this in half. And all you got to do to cut it in half is fold it in half and then go right across that folded half. Okay. We have two pieces here. We're going to make the stuffing area in the back. So I'm going to put the pretty sides together and sew this up on the machine, leaving a space right here in the middle. Let me go do that and I'll be right back. All right, I'm back. I've sewn my two pieces together. You can see that here's where we're going to stuff it. I've ironed the seams open. So it's just a fourth of an inch seam allowance, the two pretty sides together. You sew it straight down, leaving a hole for stuffing. Open up the seams, press them open. There you go. Now then, I'm going to lay pretty sides together. And this is about centered. I'm going to about center this on laying on the ornament, okay, or pillow. So on the back side, this is what it looks like. There's where we'll stuff. I've got it pretty well centered. The seam is pretty well centered on the fab, on the design. Now I'm going to trim my edges. And you just want a little, you don't want to trim right along. You just want to trim right along where the cut on the pillow, the top is, the topper. I do top and bottom first. Okay, now then, we're going to throw these scraps away. All right, so pretty sides are together. I'm going to put a pin in the top to hold. And on all sides, basically, just to hold the pieces together and so nothing slips when I'm sewing them. And then I'm going to go across to the sewing machine. So meet me over there. All right, here we are at the sewing machine. Now then, since I've got my stuffing placed in the back, I don't have to start and stop for a turnout hole or a stuffing hole because this is our stuffing hole and we've already created it. So I'm ready to sew. Let me get rid of these. I don't know where these came from. Let me get rid of these straggly threads here coming off my material. All right. You're going right along the edge of the pillow topper. I lined it up. It's right, the presser foot's right on the edge. I sunk my needle. I'm going to go forward a couple stitches, go back a couple stitches to lock, and then straight on down the edge of the material to the other corner, back to lock. And we're going to pull it. I'm going to go ahead and clean my corners right now. All right, load up my fabric, sink it, you're going to hold. Now this time you're going to have to hold this little seam, the seam right here, down so that it doesn't go flipped, get flipped up, okay? Like this. You don't want that. You want it held down. Right along the edge, all the way to the other corner. Clean your corner threads. Okay, now we're going to go across the top. There's no seams to hold down on this one. Straight across. Clean our corners. All right, now we're going to go all the way from the corner to the other corner. Sink my needle, go back, reinforce. I'm going to hold down that material seam all the way straight to the other corner. All right, done. Now then, we're going to clean our corners. And now we're going to clip our corners. Okay. Oop, I want that a little bit closer. Okay, now then, throw that away. Now we're going to turn it out. Wait a minute, before we turn it out, I forgot. I want to put interfacing just on this part of the project, just so that it's smooth and white, so when we stuff it, you don't see balls of fabric. So let me go ahead, or balls of the stuffing. So let me put my interfacing on here, iron the interfacing. It's just going to be on this linen. I don't want it out here, okay? Just on the linen. So let me do that, and I'll be right back. All right, I'm back. You can see that I put interfacing on just the linen part, the cross-stitch fabric part. And the reason I do that is when you're stuffing, I want these loose, the flanges loose, okay? But when you stuff, you're stuffing with a bamboo stick, and that can get some of your threads caught and pull them, and I don't want any threads pulled. And then also, when we turn it out, and then when we stuff it, it'll be smoother if you use just a little bit of interfacing. It's the interfacing that I always use, PF 44. And that's locally available at any, it's just a light interfacing at any sewing store. Okay, we're going to turn it out. We've already clipped our corners, as you saw before. We're going to turn it out. We've got our bamboo corner poker outer. We're going to poke out the corners. I always kind of drag my bamboo stick all along that sewn seam. It all along the other sewn, along the bottom to the other corner. And then all along the sewn seam to that upper corner. Okay, let me look at my corners. Make sure they're just how I want them. Those are some pretty nice corners there. Okay, now then, what I'm going to do is I'm going to lay this flat down and I'm going to iron this. And then we're going to go over to the sewing machine and we're going to create our flanges. I'll meet you there in just a moment. All right, I'm back. I have ironed my piece. I ironed it from the back side down with a little bit of steam. You can see it's perfectly flat. Now then, we're going to make our flange. And how we do that is we are going to sew with our presser foot right along this edge all the way around the face of the ornament, okay? Now then, we're not going to go back and forth and do like we do when we sew. It's just going to be one continuous sewing line around the face of the ornament. So that means you got to be kind of careful. You got to go slow. So I'm going to put my speed governor on slow. Okay, and you want to do that too if you have a speed governor, or just don't press down like we're going to town. Okay, we're going to start down here in this lower corner, because if you're setting a pillow in a bowl, where are your eyes going to be located? They're going to be looking up here. They're not going to be seeing stuff down here. So if we mess up, it's better to mess up on the bottom rather than on the top. So we're going to put our lower right hand corner edge in the sewing machine. Now then, where do we start sewing? We start with where the hole is on your presser foot. Let me take this off so you can see this. Right here, where my presser foot is, I'm going to line up the corner with this hole right there where the needle goes up and down. Okay? Okay, just right behind where that hole is where the corner is, okay? I'm going to sink my needle. I'm going to increase my stitch length to 3.5 because I kind of want it big. I kind of want it to look like it's quilted, okay? Sink my, you don't even have to do that. I just do that, but you don't have to, okay? So I'm going to start sewing. I'm going to go forward one. I'm going to go back one to lock it, okay? And then slowly, slowly, I'm going straight across to this other corner. My presser foot is right along the edge of the material and the linen. When I get to this other corner, I want to go right out 2 stitches from the edge. Turn it. Oop, I need to go just a little bit more. One more stitch. And so I'm going to do that by hand. Then I'm going to turn and I'm going to go right up again. Right to the corner. And then I'm going to turn it and I'm going to go right again. It again, and then I'm going to meet my other corner and we're going to end off. When you get to where you started sewing, you're going to go back one to lock, forward to lock, and that's it. Now then, you just have to clean your threads. And you can see that I have sewn all around the face a square of thread. This is our flange and will not be stuffed. Okay? That's what creates the flange. Can you see the sewn all the way around the face of the pillow? Okay, now we're going to go back across and we're going to stuff it right in here. Okay? Give me just a minute to get the stuffing. All right, here we are. We're getting ready to stuff I got a needle with a single strand of thread and a knot on the end, ready to go. Got my stuffing, and I got my handy dandy chopstick. Okay, what are we doing? We're gonna loft the fiber fill, or the polyfill, whatever you want to call it, stuffing. Stick it in. Now, I will say these flange pillows don't need to be layered or stuffed quite as thickly as I stuff my ornaments. Okay? I'm just working in some holes. I always still feel with my hand where are their holes. And then you just add a little bit of stuffing. I think that's about all I want. So now I'm going to sew up this back edge. Oh, wait a minute. I feel a little wonky donk right through there. I'm going to pin it to see how it will look in the front. Okay, so you can see that it's generally pretty smooth. Right there in this one corner though, see right here, a little bit of a wrinkle. Still just a little bit. I can see it on camera. Okay, that's much better. Okay, so I'm going to take my needle and I'm going to do a blind stitch. It's already got a knot in it. I'm going to do a blind stitch up the middle, because we want this to be pretty and you don't see any stitches. Okay. So to do a blind stitch, I'm going to go up here along the hem, the fold, and just take a little bite. It's hard to do it trying to show it to a camera without grabbing polyfill. Okay, then I'm going to go on the bottom right along the seam, okay? Right along the seam. I'm just going to take a little bite. Tiny. And pull it. And you keep on going just right along that folded edge or the seam or whatever you want to call it. And as you take the, you just pull it to sew it up. It's like sewing up a, making a back and forth, almost like ladder rungs. Can see it. Okay, those are the stitches I'm taking. See, just back and forth like a ladder rung, and then you just gently pull. See? Let me finish this, and then I'll show you the final product. Here we are. Here we are with our finished flanged pillow. Again, I just took an iron on low steam. I ironed it gently, put a little bit of pressure on the back to smooth it. You can see there's no lumps. No bumps, completely smooth. And then I took it around the edge of the flange to make sure they were all straight and perfectly pressed. And there, my friends, is a simple flange pillow, perfectly done.